I have no words of wisdom for you at the top of this episode. There is no effort to be profound here. I'll just say this. Hosting the Chris Gethard Show, it's one of my dreams come true. And tonight, I'm using it as an excuse to try and make one of my other dreams come true. I've always wanted to dunk a basketball, just like my favorite player of all time, John Starks, who will be here watching as I most likely humiliate myself. Enjoy the Chris Gethard Show.
Show with sidekick Shannon O'Neill, internet liaison Bethany Hall, the creature from the sea, the human fish, the greatest house in the world, the LLC. We got John Hodgman in the studio and former New York Nick, John Starks. And later on, we got music from Pitch Black Brass Band. Well, I blew my load a bit early and now there's no more music, but I'm already slam drunk, so let's get it going. Let's give it up for Chris Gethard.
Show. Thank you, Murph, for the stunning intro. A lot of words tonight, man.
Got through it.
You did. You got through it. Thank you, LLC, for the music. Thank you guys all for watching and supporting our show. Very, very excited. Tonight, ladies and gentlemen, I'm calling my shot right out of the gate. I will fulfill a lifelong dream. Tonight, I will dunk a basketball. I promise you that. It's going to get done. Shannon will be joining me. Also, another person, I believe for the first time, you guys know I'm the star of Stages and Screens, and also you know the Judge John Hodgman podcast. John Hodgman, how are you?
I'm very well, thank you. How are you?
I'm great. I'm nervous.
I love sports.
You do? Yeah. This is the thing. Have you dunked a basketball before?
Which one is that?
That's this one. It's that one right there.
No, I never have.
Are you looking for, because you're down. You're going to go for it as well. We will both dunk by the end of this night.
Well... Some of that might be true.
Yeah. We're at least
going to
try.
I'm definitely going to try.
Yeah.
I'm looking forward to it very much.
And we should say, I'm going to, full disclosure, say, I jumped off this trampoline to test its safety. I believe you did the same.
Yes.
I did not use a basketball.
No, I did not. I didn't try it.
You didn't?
No, because what does practice get anyone?
It's true. It's true. Right. I did not try it with a basketball. I know that thing won't fall apart if my body hits it. That's what I established. Right. I'll be trying to dunk for the first time live on the air tonight.
Me too.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's going to be a real good time. And joining us, I can't imagine a better person to teach us about how to dunk, the glories of dunking. I am a massive, massive, lifelong New York Knicks fan. I cannot believe the person who's sitting across from me right now. Ladies and gentlemen, John Starks is here. Incredible. And I feel like I just want to say a couple things, because I feel like our fans traditionally not always sports fanatics. I myself, I'm a basketball fanatic. I root Knicks. I root Seton Hall when it comes to college. I watch everything. My wife and I would go to games every year. And I need to say, if you are not aware of this, there is one dunk in NBA history known as the dunk. There's a lot of dunks. There's a lot of people known for dunks. Amari Stoudemire, Blake Griffin, Vince Carter, Tracy McGrady. They're all known for dunks. But when you say the dunk, it refers to a very specific dunk and a very specific moment from my childhood. It refers to this man right here dunking over Michael Jordan in the playoffs. One of the most amazing moments in sports history, if you ask me. A lot of Bulls fans, including JD and including Will Miles, who helps make up the ideas for our show, they like to say you dunked over Horace Grant and Jordan was nearby. No! You dunked over Jordan and Horace Grant was nearby. And I just have to say, it's true. And I just have to say, our show has this reputation for being like an underdog show that keeps fighting. And I always think about how the fact that I grew up loving not just the Knicks, but your generation, the Knicks, you, Oakley, Ewing, I know I'm getting cheesy. I'm about to start crying. We haven't even started the show. But I always felt like those Knicks, you guys, it breaks my heart to say it, never won that championship. I won it every year, but now
breaks
I'm an adult.
Too.
I can't imagine. But I look back and I'm like, man, but you know what? Those Bulls always limped. They limped into the finals. Because you guys always, when Jordan played Starks, he always had a bloody lip and a black eye by the time he got to the finals. No matter what, you let him know, and I'm on the verge of weeping. So I'm going to calm down, but I can't explain how much being a New York Knicks fan has informed my ability to just try to scrap at all times with my career. So thank you, sir,
for that. You're welcome.
I mean that so truly from the bottom of my heart. Sorry it got weird. Immediately.
No, that's okay. I'll just let you go on and on. You got the vent.
We'll move on.
I got a little choked up there. Like caring about sports, I feel like this is what it must be like to be a normal human. And I'm very
not
grateful.
Normal, huh? No.
And thank you also, you brought, you're here, Zipway Sports, right? Is your new, we're all meeting myself. You, Shannon, Bethany, looking lovely in Zipway tonight.
I feel really cool right now.
You look really cool.
I've been pulling off my pants all day.
Tearaway pants. To give that some needed context, they are tearaway pants.
Yeah.
Designed for that purpose. You're not just sexually harassing
everyone. Do you want me to show you?
Yeah,
if you want
please.
To.
Yes, please.
Yeah, Bethany, let's get up.
That's zipper technology.
This is zipper technology.
And I hope that's a swivel chair.
I also want to point out that these are children's pants and they're way too big for me.
Wow. Well, I noticed that I didn't get a jumpsuit. It's cool.
Yeah, there must have been a miscommunication there.
It's fine. I brought my own sports togs. So
you did.
Yeah, my own. I have my own sports things, so I'll just change.
You're changing right here on the show.
Could you untake my shoe off? I want to keep it moving along.
Yeah.
It's
a very nice shoe.
It was made for me, so it might take some time.
It is. It's a very well-fitting shoe.
Yeah.
The leather's beautiful.
Okay, hurry up.
I know I have a knot situation. I'm sorry. Go.
Good.
Okay. The mic. Okay, your mic.
Yeah, no, I...
We have a mic. We need sound.
Yeah. Mr. John Starks, would you hand me my shorts, please?
Hey, there you go, sir.
John Starks handing John...
This is as sexual as the show ever
gets. It's true. It is true.
About as sexual as I ever get. I have my jersey, too, for my favorite sports team.
Okay.
Do you ever make dress shirts with zippers? Because that would really help right now.
If this was a tearaway,
yeah.
A tearaway shirt would really come in handy right now.
Tearaway Brooks Brothers action.
Tonight.
This is my own shirt from home.
Wow, and I believe that is not a basketball jersey at all.
Oh, is it not? I don't know. It's it's my favorite sports team, the Hartford Whalers.
Hartford Whalers, the Whale.
John Starks knows.
Yeah.
I'm a big fan of extinct hockey teams.
Yes. So. I was going to say, I believe that hockey team has not existed for...
20 years next year.
Wow.
Because I buy a new one every day, so...
You look perfect. Color coordination.
No shoes.
We're all ready to go. And tonight, you know, we like to mix different types of culture here at the show. So basketball is one culture. We wanted to mix it with a little bit of high culture. What goes better with slam dunks than slam poetry? Ladies and gentlemen, tonight, slam dunks and slam poetry here on the Chris Gethard Show.
Slam dunks! Slam dunks! Slam dunks!
Slam poetry!
Okay. We've got a trampoline set up. I need to know. So, Mr. Starks, what do I need to know going into this? How do I dunk? How will dunking change my approach to life? I feel like it's going to change my confidence level out of the gate. Is that true? Am I assuming too much?
No, it's going to take you to a whole nother level that you've never been.
It's true. Yeah, mentally, it's true. It readjusts
mentally,
you?
It's like euphoric.
Is it possible for you to have a bad day? Is it possible? Because, like, when bad stuff happens to me, I wallow in it. But are you just like, I dunked on Jordan? That's it.
You know, I got a big painting of that in my house.
I have a signed photo up in my house.
Okay, can I talk about this for a second?
Yeah, my wife. That's my wife, Hallie.
Okay, so we have a shelf. Hi. We have a shelf in our house that has, like mostly family photos. Yeah. There's, like, a picture of my father fishing when he was a young child. Uh-huh. There's, like, mementos from vacations we've taken. And then there's a picture of you doing the dunk.
It's so...
Now, since neither of us have ever slam dunked a basketball before, do you remember the first time you did and how it felt, and was it hard to do? Those are some questions.
That's a great question. That's a great question.
That's a very good question. I did it when I was 7 years old.
Seven?
What?
You're 35, man. So you dunked when you were seven?
It's a story behind that, though.
Okay.
Okay. My brother was over playing in a neighbor's backyard, and after they got through playing, I asked them, could I play? What they gonna say? No, you can't play. So I'm watching them jump off a big old oil barrel and fly through there and dunk the basketball. So once they left, I picked up their basketball and did the same thing. Flew through the air and dunked it. I was hooked on basketball forever.
That was it?
That was it.
First time?
First time.
Well.
I had some help, though. Just like y'all gonna have some help.
Yeah, but I guarantee you, it won't be first time. it may be last time.
Yeah.
Did you keep that oil barrel?
No.
No. Okay.
It's on Gethard shelf, I think.
Okay, I think it's time for us to attempt our first dunks. I'll go, then Shannon will go, then Mr. Hodgman will go, and Mr. Sarge, maybe you can give us some constructive criticism on what we can change for next time. I hope this goes well. I hope no one gets hurt. Okay.
Perfect.
Okay.
Make sure you build up your speed.
A lot of speed?
A lot of speed.
Speed is not necessarily my strong point in life. I think mostly my strong points are like I'm a good listener and I'm a pretty empathetic person. Or do those come in handy with this at all?
That helps.
Being a good listener will help me dunk. That's good.
I think you are probably about 7 feet, 8 feet.
Feeling real genuine fear and real insecurity that you're watching this.
That's all right. I was insecure when I made that dunk, too. I had millions of people watching me. Okay.
Got it, John Starks.
Okay.
Ready, Shannon?
Oh. Yep. You're going. I'm ready for you.
He's good right now. Let's go. Let's go, Chris.
Shannon, that felt so f***ing good.
Okay.
That felt so amazing. Pretty good.
You made the bucket.
Made the bucket. John Hodgman. John Hodgman, I want to point out they are adjusting the mats, anticipating a disaster.
No.
Clearly anticipating a disaster.
You got to visualize what you're going to do.
I'm just going
to
walk up there.
No, you're not going to walk. You can't walk. Speed. I need speed from you.
To a fantastic start, a better start than I thought we'd get to. We only go onward and upward from here. Murph, take us out to commercial, man.
That might be the sound of the first buzzer, but don't go away. Mimi ain't the only one on the hoops tonight.
Welcome back to the Chris Gethard Show. We're here with John Hodgman. We're here with John Starks. We're dunking basketballs. I feel great. There's another person I want to check in with, a person who's a part of our show. He's not even really a person. He's a creature from the sea. I want to know how he's feeling as he witnesses this go down. Human Fish, what's on your mind?
NCAA versus ABBA.
Ooh, the NCAA versus ABBA. I believe it's a Swedish pop group. Saying Dancing Queen. Who wins?
Dancing Queen. Yeah,
that is copyrighted. You can't sing that. Say hello to our guests, Human Fish.
Hi, John Starks. Hi,
John.
How
you doing? Benjamin. How you doing, Human Fish?
Okay, I felt great about that dunk. Do you remember? Is there a particular dunk from your career that you're like, that was the one? That's the one I dream about at night.
Probably the one when I dunked on AC Green.
AC
no,
Green.
No, excuse me. Not was it AC Green? Yeah. I dunked on so many. I'm thinking it was AC Green. Yeah. I'm trying to think of it. Oh, no, Mark West.
Mark West.
Played for Phoenix.
Yeah.
I went baseline and you know, he's 6 foot 10, about 272.
Yeah, he had like a red beard, right?
No.
Is that that guy?
No, that's Dennis Rodman, I think.
Nailed it. You nailed that.
Long ponytail. Okay.
You nailed that.
Viking hat, maybe? Yeah.
But anyway, I went up and caught him in his chest and pushed off, and I was just floating. And I was like, how should I dunk this? One hand, maybe turn backwards, and I just like smashed him.
Does it feel like time is passing slowly as you approach the... Or, like, you can make choices
very
like,
slow-mo.
Here's how I'm going to show this guy I'm the best.
Does he know at that point this looks bad?
He knows it's up with.
Is it slow motion for him as well?
Yeah, it is. Yeah.
He knows, like, this is...
Every time he see me to this day, he look at me like, I know.
Whoa. Now, Mr. Hodgman, what do I have to do to help you feel that tonight? Is there any part of you that says if you were inspired perhaps by some poetry that it might help you achieve even greater heights of dunking?
Well, poetry always does help.
Yeah.
Absolutely. That's why they recite poems at NBA games, right?
Always. I believe it's...
Coaches do.
Yeah.
Always. Okay. Luckily, a lot of our callers happen to be poetry fans. This is true. Many of our callers are Skyping in tonight, ready to read their favorite poems. Will you, myself, and Shannon just take turns dunking two poems, merging the world of poetry and dunking. I really want to challenge the three of us to interpret the poetry via our dunks, interpretive dunks. I nailed my first one.
Yeah, you did. That was perfect.
Any challenges, any adjustment, any types of dunks you want to see me pull off?
That was an easy dunk for you, but I want you to go and turn and dunk backwards. Oh.
Reverse dunk. Huh? Yes, John Starks, I will do this for you. I will do this for you. Let's get it done.
All right.
Who's up first on Skype?
Let's talk to Katie from CT.
Katie from Connecticut.
Yeah. How are you?
How are you tonight? Do you have a favorite poem?
If I Should Die by Emily Dickinson.
Ooh, Emily Dickinson. Ooh. That's very inspiring.
What's this poem about? If I Die? Is that what it's called?
Whenever you want to start reading it.
All right. If I should die, and you should live, and time should girdle on, and morn should be, and noon should burn.
No. That was my fault. That was a bad pass.
No, that was a bad pass. John Starks, you're perfect.
Field is early, and bees as bustling go. One might depart an option.
That was terrifying.
That stocks will stand when we with daisies lie, that commerce will continue and trades as briskly fly. It makes the party tangle.
That's the mirror right there.
So
Wow. Wait, is the poem over?
That was it. Very short.
That's a short poem. What do we do? Next poem, okay, Bethany, who's up next? Thank you so much for Emily Dickinson, I felt good.
Noah from LA.
Noah from LA, welcome to the show.
Hey everyone, what's up?
Not much, we're just here dunking basketballs with John Starks while other people read poetry and John Hodgman's here. It's a fun night, a little bit of a weird night, but I think everybody's having a good time.
Mm-hmm. It's been going great.
Thank you so much.
Talent.
So do you have a poem you'd like to read tonight?
I do, it's called A Bouquet by Edward Smith Jones.
Okay, and tell us a little bit about what you think might inspire us to greater dunking heights via this poetry.
You know, this poem's about true love, and I think, you know, if you guys just put your heart into it, you can do anything.
There you go.
Thank you so much, Noah from LA. Start reading, Noah, whenever you want.
A blossom pink, a blossom blue, all there is in love so true. To strip me thinks my heart to move, to give it ease, to
girl
I know. Thank you so much.
Now take it, dear, this morning wear a wreath of beauty in thy hair. Think on it, when from bliss you part, the end of my wooing heart.
Damn it. It's my t-. It's too big.
Whoa!
No, leave it there.
Whoa! Shannon, go! Shannon, you got this. Keep reading, Noah. Keep reading.
A blossom pink, a blue, make all there is.
Wow. We have all successfully dunked. We have all successfully dunked. That's amazing. I think we have to take a break.
Hodgman's calves
killing
are incredible.
It. We have to get a look at John Hodgman's calves. These are amazing calves. What a specimen. What a specimen. Incredible. I'm feeling good.
They're the only part of me that's not asthmatic.
Wow. All three of us have dunked. I'm feeling good. Are you guys feeling good?
Oh, yes.
Thank you so much.
Beautiful.
You feeling good about it?
Yeah, I'm feeling great.
Amazing.
Yeah.
Let's take a break. Murph, get us out of here.
Don't you dare go away, because there are more epic dunks. your future. Stick around. God Starks is here.
Here, we're back. We had to kind of take a breath. John Hodgman, yeah. Our guest tonight, dunking the basketball. You went a little shack. You shacked it.
Yeah.
It was the closest I've felt to slow motion in my life.
Really? Talk us through this.
And I saw it, like I was up there, and I know I have this one. Yeah. And I saw that rim, and I had two thoughts. One, that's a cool thing to do, grab it. I'm not sure.
It was.
But
it was.
That's my move. Uh-huh. And then two, if I grab it, maybe I won't hit the ground so hard. And so I grabbed it, and then it...
You break your fall.
Yeah. It but it's not a cool thing to grab the rim.
No.
Well,
no.
It came down with you was the problem.
No, but in real basketball, that would be...
That's a good thing.
That's a good thing?
Yeah, that's a good thing.
But
yeah.
In this, it's not good.
I do want to point out, I don't know if we have a camera that can adequately get a shot of this. We did, don't worry, professionally fixed it. We tied it to our set with one short piece of clothesline. So... Yeah, I think everything's good.
12 men swooped in
and that's
tied it up with a single rope. Yeah.
So at this point, all three of us have successfully dunked. I honestly felt more adrenaline than I felt in years. How do you guys feel?
Great.
I'm never sleeping again.
Never. You're done with sleep.
This is it. And I'm going to be so productive.
Now that we have dunked, what are our lives going to be like moving forward?
When you walk out on the street, people are going to recognize you a little bit more. They're going to say... He was on that show.
I'll go, yeah.
Yeah, you go, that's me.
Well, the energy's about to go through the roof, because I know I go to a lot of games, specifically college games. I found that my wife tends to enjoy college games because a lot more, there's marching bands, there's dance teams, there's cheerleaders, there's a lot of activities. And I wanted to make sure we brought a really strong halftime show. Luckily, we did find a mascot on Craigslist who was willing to come grace us with his presence. So very, very fortunate to have our mascot tonight. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the one, the only, Scuzzy, the basketball cat.
Come on! Come on! Come on! Come on!
Wow. 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 I'm so sorry. Why don't I just take that? Your head.
Scuzzy! Scuzzy's here! Coming through the scuzz hole. Scuzzy! Ryan, you want a French kiss, Scuzzy? Oh, French kiss, Scuzzy. Yeah!
Scuzzy, I'm sorry, I'm a little overwhelmed. You've never seen an act start like that where you come out and your head falls off onto that guy Mikey who comes to the show a lot.
You drink nasal spray. You get it. You get what Scuzzy does he? Right now, you're not on nasal spray, and you're like, huh? But Scuzzy knows. Scuzzy knows.
I'm going to have to just take a step back from this and ask what your deal is, Scuzzy. I mean, we paid good money for a mascot show. I feel like
yesterday,
we're not...
I found this outside the dumpster I've been sleeping in. And I was like, oh, Shark Tank business idea. I'm putting this on Craigslist. Oh, sucker, come along and buy. It's a Scuzzy here. What's up?
Yeah, what is that? That's a cat?
Yeah, it's a Scuzz. And he's got some, ooh, dry, crusty stuff around his mouth.
God.
Scuzzy does what he must he do to make a buck or two.
It's funny you said that in rhyme, because we're doing like a whole poetry and basketball themed of comedy here. That was kind of poetic.
I don't like poetry, but I do like dried nasal spray.
Oh.
You dry it out in the sun on a piece of aluminum. Cut it on up, and what's up? Shark Tank. That's what's happening.
Your drug of choice is dried nasal spray?
Yeah.
That's a thing you sniff. Huh? When you dry it, it becomes a... Oh.
Hey!
That's Joe. Hey! 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 That's a legend. That's an NBA All-Star.
Well, welcome to the club.
Reason why I'm checking... this looks like one of my ties went missing. So it's like, I don't know, Scuzzy.
Scuzzy doesn't know it.
Yeah, Scuzzy, I think you know, Scuzzy.
Any ties?
I think you know.
Mm-hmm. Scuzzy?
Scuzzy's not a cat burglar! Not today.
Wait, I feel like Scuzzy's the mascot. We were calling him Scuzzy, but this is a what is your name? What's your name?
John Scuzzy.
Your name is John Scuzzy.
Scuzzy. Of the Westerfield Scuzzies.
Wow.
You've probably heard of Darren Scuzzy.
I've heard of Darren, the billionaire industrialist.
Mm-hmm. Is that your brother?
No, no relation.
Wow. Well, I'm really, also, just so you know, you do have fuzz over most of your head. There's a lot of, on the...
But it's not from this. Scuzzy likes what's fuzzy. Oh, does he? Mm-hmm.
Wow.
That's how many people make money. If they don't have TV shows.
What?
Elaborate. What is it that they do with fuzz?
Who wants their eaten?
Okay. Okay, that's enough.
Fuzzy.
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 That is
Fuzzy.
Not. That's
enough.
Scuzzy, no.
That is not Shark Tank.
No.
That is not Shark Tank.
No. That is not Shark Tank.
Scuzzy, I'm really sorry. You have to leave. I'm going to have to ask you to leave right now. We have a show to get back to. It's going really well.
I saw some hands when I said $3 for it. So I ain't going anywhere.
I don't think anybody's into it. What do I have to do? What do I have to do to move on with this show?
You don't have to give Scuzzy anything. But, John, can I keep the tie?
I want Scuzzy to dunk.
Yeah, I was thinking the same thing. Scuzzy.
Just be very careful. Just be very, very careful.
Scuzzy.
Now remember, this is a broken man about to dunk on a broken poop. This is probably the best and worst idea ever.
Scuzzy.
Bethany, I'm not so sure.
Oh, yeah, take your oven mitts off.
I don't know if we even touch that.
Scuzzy!
I don't know if we even want to touch that.
Scuzzy! Scuzzy!
Scuzzy! Scuzzy! Scuzzy! Scuzzy! Scuzzy! Scuzzy! Oh, no. Oh, no, no, no. Come on, Scuzzy.
Don't touch his butt. Wait, let's just...
He's not moving.
No, let's just get a sheet and wrap him up and roll him out.
Okay, we're going
to... Then we go to commercial and we drag him out.
Okay, Murph, go to commercial. We're going to clear out Scuzzy. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, Scuzzy the cat.
Yikes! I got to hit the showers after that one, Lata. Don't go away! We'll be right back. Scuzzy won't, but we will.
Welcome back to the Chris Gethard Show. We've been having a fun night. John Starks is in the chat room right now with Bethany and a bunch of our fans. John Hodgman not only dunking, breaking basketball rims.
Sorry about that.
No worries at all. I'd have it no other way. I imagine our line producer who handles the budget is not as thrilled as I am. That being said, we're going to slow things down a little bit. We're going to show you guys a video, and this is very true. Before he was the announcer on our show, before he was a man about town, and before he had... such a dark side that was embraced and then walked away from. Our guy Murph was a very, very high-level high school baseball player. This is totally true, Murph.
It's truth, yep.
One thing that we've done recently, 100% true, is we sent Murph to audition for a minor league baseball team.
Hey, buddy. We're gonna stretch, we're gonna train a little bit, I'm gonna hit you some fly balls. I'm gonna work you a little bit today.
All right.
You say all right, but I'm...
Oh, I know. I gotta get with it. I need my morning deuce.
You are a human vice, you know that?
Can't live this way forever, you know? You gotta enjoy it while you're young.
You're not young.
That's fair.
Let's get out of here.
I'm Murph Meyer, and it's been a lifelong dream of mine to play professional baseball. I'm now 34 years old, but I was one hell of a ball player in high school. Drugs and alcohol and other things kind of derailed that dream a little bit. But now here I am 17 years later, and I want to give it a shot. Turns out the Somerset Patriots are holding an open tryout. That's my window.
I stretch that into a deuce.
We'll go home run trot the rest of the way, huh?
Just rotate those hips. There you go. Ooh.
Let me just borrow that man's body. Can't triple.
There you go. There you go. There you go. Go down there. There you go, buddy. What are you?
Grade A beef.
How you cooked?
Medium rare.
Am I finding you at Peter Luger's?
Nah.
How about McDonald's?
Nah.
Oh, maybe an Outback Steakhouse?
Yeah.
That's right, run of the mill, baby. Ah.
He's coming home. Here's a throw.
This is the one you carb up, right? You carb up and then you go. Yes, sir. We're up here in 215. I would love to get a shout at like 6 a.m. I'm trying out for the Somerset Patriots tomorrow. I don't know why I thought if I told them I was trying out, it would be more of a legitimate wake-up call.
I think you were really telling yourself more than anyone.
Yeah,
probably.
Yeah, that was for me.
Yeah.
Here we go.
Ooh, bro, that does not sound good, man.
No, I mean, there we go. The North and South are battling. The Confederacy, oh, and the Union.
Yeah, that's the Civil War in a nutshell.
It's been an intense couple of weeks of training, and I feel better than I have in years. This is my time. I think if I was ever going to do this, it's now.
If I had a kid the last time I played, he would he'd be old enough to try out.
It's a beautiful observation. Go get him, all right? I've done all I can. Come here. You got this, all right? Yeah, I got him.
I was anxious to get out there, and then they sit everybody down and tell us that the field's in no condition for a tryout, so that they're sending everyone home except the pitchers and catchers. So I said, the hell with it. Put me on the bump.
Pitching is one of the hardest things in all professional sports. We spent zero time pitching.
I'm out there giving it all I got, and they put me next to this kid who's throwing 95 mile an hour fastballs. I mean, Jesus, it's like trying out for a team next to Ron Jeremy. By the end of it, it was clear I wasn't impressing anyone.
Thanks, man.
Think if you had to say my chances of making the squad, should I wait by the phone? Or?
Minimal, yeah. But there's always a chance, you know what I mean?
Yep.
It's kind of like the Dumb and Dumber, where he says you're saying there's a chance? I'd say it's about like that, you know what I mean?
Just taking a quick one. I needed to see if I could still get out there and step on the field, and I don't think I embarrassed myself. My old man's gonna be proud.
I gave it an effort, you know?
Hey, man, we tried.
I think I'll go destroy one of these bathrooms. Go up in the luxury box and just ruin it.
Sounds like a plan.
Murph, so sorry to see how that turned out, but you know, you always have a home with us. We love you here, and you're always welcome. Let's take a minute, catch our breath, let you process those emotions. LLC, get us out of here. Welcome back. Thank you, everybody, for watching the Chris Gethard Show. And I just want to say, it is not often that you get to hang out with someone who is a legitimate hero from your childhood. Let's please have a hand for Mr. John Starks, ladies and gentlemen. All right. Ladies and gentlemen, we, of course, are merging slam dunks with poetry tonight. I think we've had a lot of slam dunks, it's fair to say, and it's time for us to up the ante on poetry. So let's please welcome our friends from the Extreme Slam Dunk Team, a.k.a. a number of Walt Whitmans, who will now dunk over John Hodgman while he reads the poems of Walt Whitman. How are you, gentlemen? Walt Whitman, nice to meet you. Walt Whitman, Walt Whitman, we have three Walt Whitmans. Hodgman, are you a fan of Mr. Walt Whitman?
Sure, of course, I'm a big fan of poetry. I'm feeling a little down about my outfit right now. I thought this hockey jersey would be a great idea, and I just realized I look like Kevin Smith's accountant. But these guys have really cheered me up. They're singing My Body Electric, and I'm gonna read this beautiful poem.
Okay.
And I guess I'll sit on this stool over here and do it.
Beautiful. Again, ladies and gentlemen, John Hodgman reads the words of Walt Whitman while Walt Whitman's dunk over him. So simple.
Oh, Captain, my Captain, by Walt Whitman. Oh, Captain, my Captain, our fearful trip is done. The ship has weathered every rack. The prize we sought is won. The port is near. The bells I hear. The people all exulting. While follow eyes the steady keel, the vessel grim, daring. But oh, heart, heart, heart. Oh, the bleeding drops of red, where on the deck my captain lies, fallen, cold and dead. Oh, Captain, my Captain, rise up and hear the bells. Rise up, for you the flag is flung, for you the bugle trills. For you, bouquets and ribboned wreaths. For you, the shores a-crowding. Oh! For you, they call the swaying mass, their eager faces turning. Here, Captain, dear father, the arm beneath your head. It is some dream that on the deck you've fallen cold and dead. My captain does not answer. It's f***ing poetry. I'll start from the last stanza. My captain does not answer. His lips are pale and still. My father does not feel my arm. He has no pulse nor will. The ship is anchored safe and sound. Its voyage closed and done. From fearful trip, the victor ship comes in, its object won. Exult, O shores, and ring, O bells. But I, with mournful tread, walk the deck my captain lies. Fallen, cold, and dead.
Oh. Wow. 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 Beautiful. Ladies and gentlemen, John Hodgman and the Extreme Slam Dunk Team. Truly terrifying. Truly terrifying. Thank you guys so much.
When do they do their part?
They were doing it the whole time, and what? It was really scary because you broke the f***ing rim. Everyone was scared the whole time.
One more. This one's one.
Yes, there we go. Murph, get us the commercial on that happy note.
Don't you go too far, my little poets. We'll be right back after the break with music from Pitch Black Brass Band. And the whole goddamn set may come down. Who knows?
Don't. I get the next one.
Welcome back to the Chris Gethard Show. I want to thank everybody for watching tonight. Your support means the world. I want to thank John Hodgman for coming by. Pulling a shack. I want to thank the Extreme Slam Dunk Team for keeping us safe and putting on an act. And of course, John Starks, thank you for coming by. And I just mentioned John Hodgman. He's one of the kindest guys I've ever met. Every interaction we've ever had has been pleasant. Support this man, support his work, support the Judge John Hodgman podcast, and also support our musical guests tonight. This, I think, is going to blow
everybody's minds. Just as my mind was blown tonight by the fact that I got to dunk in front of one of my heroes and I got to do a thing that I never thought I was going to be able to do. And I would just say, if you're out there, you got an opportunity like that, go for it. Why sit around waiting? Find a way to make it happen. I got a TV show and then used it as an excuse to hang out with John Starks, human fish. Into it. Our musical guests tonight, I think every fan of our show is immediately going to be a fan of them. I think everyone's going to run out and get this tonight. They're playing the last Sunday of each month at the Manhattan Inn in Greenpoint, Brooklyn. So if you ever come through New York, check it out. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Pitch Black Brass Band.
Dude.